Welcome to a new episode on my Weidmüller Automation Controller series. And today I will be talking about the U-Link Remote Access feature, which is available for the automation controller. This is not actually related to, you know, programming and using the PLC. It is more about how you access the PLC if you are not on site. So it's all about remote access and, of course, internet security and information security, which, to be honest, is a very important part of any IT systems nowadays, especially any IoT systems where, you know, information security tend to be less of a focus in the past. And we have all seen these reports in the news that, you know, your local utility or the fridges inside your local grocery store just being on the open internet and anyone can, you know, look at the data, not to mention even, you know, changing some of the settings. With the U-Link remote access, you can access your PLCs, or in this case the automation controller, remotely outside from your premise, and you can do it yourself as well. Or this is also a great platform to allow external contractors or service engineers to be able to connect to your PLC and, let's say, debug it in case something happens or your setup goes down for any reason. And for those who are watching my Weidmüller series for the first time, I just want to know that there is an entire playlist about the Weidmüller Automation Controller, which runs Node-RED, and this is just one of the installments. So you go down to the video description where you will find the link to the entire playlist with videos that I've produced so far. So let's talk about this U-Link remote access and how you set it up. So this is the webpage that we have seen in the previous video as well, and you can access the U-Link from here. So in settings, U-Link settings, or you can just click on this U-Link remote access in the apps. When you open this for the first time, this page is going to look a slightly bit different. I've already done the registration, so here for me it shows that the device is already registered and it's actually enabled on the U-Link, and there is some, you know, heartbeat which is already connected. The VPN is not connected at all. So first thing that we need to do is we need to open the U-Link web portal. So you just click here and that opens the U-Link web portal, which I've already done. And of course, I've already logged in and registered. In the beginning, you just get an empty login screen, but there is going to be a registration link. So you click there, you provide your email address and your other login credentials, and you will be able to register. Once the registration is done, you receive a confirmation email, and within that email, you just have to click on a link. And then once the confirmation is done, you would be able to log into this portal that you see here. First of all, I want to mention that there are some paid components of this service, but everything that I'm showing in this video, I was able to set up without paying anything. So all the features I'm showing now is included in the free, you know, U-Link remote access service. So the first thing that we note here is there is a welcome page with news and downloads. So you can see that there is a section for which says news from your administrator. So you can leave some news here for some of the other users or the service technicians who would be logging into your system. And also you find some tutorial videos and some of the application components that we are going to use later on. The only thing we need to download for the time being is the U-Link VPN client for Windows PC. You just click on this one and then you install it. It's a regular Windows installation package, nothing special about that. With this done, we can explore the rest of the menu. Under the user profile, you can set up your user ID or you can change your own settings. The only important thing that we need to use later on is this activation code, which you are going to find in the activation code. And as you can see, I've already used this activation code. I'm just going to get to a little bit later. I'm going to skip the service. I go to straight to administration. Here in the user management, you can create multiple users. So I'm the administrator of my account. So let's assume that this is the account for the plant where I have all the different PLCs and I'm the administrator, but I can create additional users. And those users could be, for example, service technicians, internal or external people that need to access my Weidmüller devices remotely. I'm going to use my own user ID, so I don't need to create additional users. And of course, once you create users, you can assign them different roles, who would be just a service technician, who would be administrators. The next is going to be the device management. And here you can set up all the different devices that you have in that let's say, in that premise or in that installation. And I've already added my automation controller. I just rename it to Node-RED. And you can just easily do this by clicking on Edit Device object. And the automation controller is part of the uControl family, so all you have to do is drag it in here. So I've already done that, I'm not going to do it again. But here, when I click on it, the name by default is uControl, so I've renamed it to Node-RED. It also has the activation code, and this is the activation code that you need to paste it in here into the device registration. So you take this code, which you see on the screen, you paste it in here, and then you click on the register button. And it's going to take a couple of seconds, maybe a few minutes, until your status changes to registered. And you can enable uLink itself by clicking on this button here, so that will turn to on. And if your automation controller has proper connection to the internet, what you will also notice, this WWH heartbeat is also going to turn to connected. And with this, we have completed the setup in the device management. The only thing that I didn't talk about is that you can also add documents and add comments to this device itself. So let's assume that you can leave useful information or documents for the service technicians that need to fix some issue. When they log in, they will be able to access these documents. Now we can head over to the service, and we can head over to service desk. And here what we can see is we can see the same device topology that we have maintained in the device management. And if we click on our Node-RED instance, then here in the actions, you can see two connection options. So I'm going to enable these by clicking on the two connect links. And what this is going to do, it's going to prepare the automation controller so it can receive a connection request over the VPN. Your automation controller doesn't need to be connected to the VPN all the time. If, let's say, all your employees are working on site and they don't need to be able to connect to the automation controller, you can leave this disconnected, and then you can just only connect it to the VPN if anyone needs to be able to connect it externally. And with these two options connected, the automation controller is now ready to receive outside connections over the VPN. And the other thing is, if I go over to the remote access, the uLink remote access page on the automation controller itself, it also shows that the VPN connection is now connected. It was disconnected previously. Unfortunately, for technical reasons, I have to go to my other laptop to do the VPN client setup, and that laptop doesn't have the screen recording set up, so I'm going to use my camera to record the screen. I did mention a few minutes ago that when you are on the homepage, you can download the VPN client. And once you install, this is how the VPN client looks like. And in the beginning, you don't have all these settings maintained, because in the configuration, you have to come here and then you have to set up your activation code. Again, this is the activation code that you find on your user page on the activation code tab. So you put this activation code in, there is like a simple wizard screen. So you have to go through the next. And at the end, you paste in your activation code. And once you have done that, you are going to see that your user details are appearing here under the connection tab. And if everything is correct, and again, if your device has proper internet connection, the WWH status is going to show connected. And actually, that's pretty much it. If you have this set up, you need to click on the Connect VPN button, wait for a few seconds, and then you will see that the client is trying to connect to your VPN server. And then after a couple of seconds, it should say that it is connected. And actually, at this point, I'm going to refer back to the original site, because as you can see, it now shows that everything is green. So the connection from my laptop to the uLink server and down to the automation controller is now active. And the automation controller is now available under this IP address, which is this VPN IP address. So all I need to do is I need to open a browser, and I just need to type in this address. And unlike other VPN connections where you connect to the internal network, with this uLink remote access, you are only connecting to the automation controller. So you won't be able to see other devices in the local network, which I think it's good. And as you can see, I'm in. So I'm in the editor of the automation controller. If I look at the global variables, then you will be able to tell that this is actually my automation controller because it has the global variables that we have seen in the previous videos. And probably we can also look at the visualization as well. Of course, this performance is going to be somewhat slower because the whole data is going through a cloud service, but you can see it works and acts exactly the same as I would be sitting on my home network and I would be accessing the automation controller locally. So you can see the UI. This is the UI that we have edited in the previous video. And of course, everything works. I can click on the push button. It does the functionality that we expect, the other one as well. And of course, if I operate the PLC physically, I just press the button which activated the digital output too. It works. So with this VPN, I have full access of the PLC. I can make the same changes that I would do if I would be sitting next to it on the same network. And once you have done editing, you can just close the portal and you can go back to the client and disconnect from the VPN. And with this, you have disconnected from the VPN. And if we head over to the Ulink website, again, you can see that this is no longer green. We have disconnected from the client. And if nobody needs to connect to the automation controller anymore, you can even disconnect it from the VPN services by clicking on the disconnect buttons. And then it goes back to the original state when how we started. So I think this would be the remote access service in a nutshell. Of course, there is a lot more functionality here. So once you install and you come to the homepage, you can look at the videos. And also there is a documentation on the Ulink service. So if you open this document, you would have an idea of the full functionality which is available here. And also this user guide is going to take you through the entire setup process, what I've just tried to summarize in this short video. So I think that would be all for today. As always, if you have questions, please ask them in the comment section below and I will try my best to answer them or get them answered for you. Thanks for watching and hopefully see you in the next video.